Writer Ernest Tiedemann's only previous screen credit prior to French Connection was 1971 blaxploitation private investigator flick Shaft. He would go on to pen the entire Shaft trilogy and 1973 Clint Eastwood starring western High Plains Drifter. His protagonists are not knights in shining armour, they're just plain nasty. They're a dire collection of racists, rapists and chauvinists, obnoxious alpha males. They are the anti-hero. Prior to The French Connection, director William Friedkin had made little worth noting, but would go on to direct horror classic The Exorcist, and following this the years would see him slide into television, most recently directing several episodes of CSI. Schneider, of Jaws fame, stars alongside Hackman as Dawes' long-suffering partner Buddy Russo. The French Connection is based on a real-world heroin drug pipeline that ran from Turkey, through France, and then onto the States in the late 60s and early 70s. Gene Hackman's James Popeye Doyle is partly based on a real-life, tough Irish-American New York City cop, involved in the investigation of the drug trafficking operation the film is named after. A man who would shoot you in the back, and our story's leading bloke. He's not particularly nice, and not exactly charming. In fact, the only thing that makes him anything near one of the good guys is that the bad guy's just that one shade darker inside, just a little bit more immoral. He made a killing at the 1971 Oscars, but has since been critically slated by American film snobs. Still widely considered a gem amongst English film publications, his love for its lack of warmth and sentimentality, seen common in patronised and patriotic Hollywood crap, shares a gritty realism and morally corrupt social dissatisfaction of British classics of the time. Double bill of Get Carter in this would be a great accompaniment to a couple of pints and a smoke on a day off with a hangover. A film that shook up an American film industry with a good kick up the arse when it needed it, and a film that mixed an intelligent eye with authentic hard knocks action. I prefer my stuntmen's bones broken, not computer generated, thanks. A little bit of blood, sweat and tears should go into a movie. It's a New York survival story where no one is perfect, where there is only different shades of grey, and only one thing is certain. Never trust the French.